Now we change from device to valve. Why we call it valve? Because AICV has ability to shut the main flow.
The AICV, Autonomous Inflow Control Valve, and the AICD, Autonomous Inflow Control Device, can choke unwanted fluids with a small movable part. However, the way they work is quite different. The AICD's movable part is a levitating disc, which moves as a result of low viscosity fluids flowing at higher velocities above the disc than below it. This means that the disc inside can never fully choke the inflow, as the AICD is dependent on a continuous flow stream in order to function. In the AICV, however, there is not only one flow path. The movable part here is a piston, which moves as a result of a second flow path, separated from the main flow. Due to this, the inlet can be completely closed, as the main flow path does not dictate the AICV's performance. Let's have a closer look at how the AICV works. The second flow path is called the pilot flow. It's created by diverting 3% of the main flow from the reservoir through what is called a laminar flow element, the LFE. This is a coiled tube that creates a pressure drop in the flow stream. The pilot flow then enters an isolated pressure chamber, which means that the pressure drop created in the LFE affects the pressure force beneath the piston. If the pressure drop in the LFE is low, then the pressure in the chamber is high, creating a high upwards force on the piston. If the pressure drop in the LFE is high, then the pressure in the chamber is low, creating a low upwards force on the piston. The fluid then flows through what is called a turbulent flow element, the TFE. This is similar to a thin plate orifice, which creates another pressure drop in the pilot flow path. The fluid will eventually exit the TFE and enter the well pipe at the well pressure. This process gives us three pressure points and two pressure drops along the pilot flow path. The first pressure point is P1, the inlet or reservoir pressure. The first pressure drop occurs in the LFE. P2 is the second pressure point, signifying the pressure force under the piston. The second pressure drop occurs in the TFE. The last pressure point is P3. This signifies the pressure inside the wellbore, which is controlled at the surface. Fluid flows will always begin at the same P1 reservoir pressure and end at the same P3 well pressure. But the P2 pressure will vary, depending on the LFE and TFE pressure drops. Both of these pressure drops are dictated by the characteristics of the fluids flowing through the AICV. Let's take a look at what happens in the valve when oil, water and gas enter the pilot flow path. We'll begin with the laminar flow element, as this is the core sensing part of the AICV. In the LFE, the fluids are forced into a slower and smoother laminar flow, making it highly sensitive to viscosity differences. Based on the LFE pressure drop equation, the pressure drop equals to 32 times viscosity times velocity times length divided by diameter squared. The length and diameter of the LFE are geometrical constants, predetermined during manufacturing. If we change all of the constant components to C, we can also write the equation in this way. The pressure drop is proportional to C times viscosity times velocity. For simplicity, let's assume that oil, water and gas will have the same velocity of 1 meter per second in the LFE. This means that higher fluid viscosity will create a high pressure drop, whereas lower fluid viscosity will create a lower pressure drop. Viscosity is measured in the unit of centipoise, CP. A medium oil can be 7 CP, water is 1 CP, and gas is 0.02 CP. This means that the LFE pressure drop is 7 times higher for oil than for water, and even higher when compared to gas. When oil is flowing, the high pressure drop in the LFE creates a low pressure in the pressure chamber below the piston at P2. This enables the higher P1 inlet pressure to push the piston down, allowing the oil to flow freely through the main flow into the well. Let's see what happens when water starts flowing through the valve. Water has a viscosity of 1 CP, meaning that the pressure drop in the LFE will be 7 times lower than for the oil, resulting in a higher P2 pressure. Now, if we follow the logic of higher pressure versus lower pressure, then the piston should not be able to move upwards, as P2 is lower than P1. However, there's another aspect to the AICV's physical principles, piston force. The isolated pressure chamber and movable part function together as a piston. Therefore, piston force will push the piston upwards, even at similar P1 and P2 pressures. This is because force equals pressure times area. And in the AICV, the area exposed to the P1 pressure, A1, is smaller than the area exposed to the P2 pressure, A2. This means that a greater force will be created below the piston than above it, which moves it upwards to close the inlet. When gas flows through the valve, which is a fluid with a viscosity of 0.02 cp, the pressure drop in the LFE will be minimal. This results in an even higher P2 pressure than for water. As P2 is exposed to the larger area A2, a greater force is created below the piston compared to the force created above it, where P1 is exposed to the smaller A1. The piston is therefore pushed upwards, choking the inflow of gas. But what happens if a lighter oil flows through the valve, with a viscosity of perhaps 1 cp, a value identical to the viscosity of water? This is where the turbulent flow element comes into play, the final pressure drop along the pilot flow path. Unlike the LFE, which is viscosity sensitive, the TFE is density sensitive. Water has a 10-20% higher density than oil, regardless of viscosity. This means that when 1 cp water and 1 cp oil are flowing through the pilot flow path, due to water's higher density, the TFE will restrict or choke more of the water than the oil as the fluids exit the pressure chamber and enter the well pipe. As a result, the pressure below the piston will be higher for water than for oil, enabling the AICV to choke water in light oil reservoirs. Because the AICV's pilot flow is separate from the main flow path, the valve's choking ability can be customized. For instance, it's possible to vary the laminar flow element's length and diameter, the diameter of the turbulent flow element, and the size of areas 1 and 2. Doing so will directly impact the fluids that are choked and how much, resulting in an inflow control specific to individual reservoir needs.